Welcome back to the GAA Handball Show. And before we return to the dynamic on-court action, we take you on our first tour of some of the latest schools reaping immense benefits from the inclusion of the One Wall Challenge initiative to their curriculum.
The last year I started when the school introduced it, and I really loved it. And it's really good for like hand-eye coordination and all that there. And it's really good crack with all the friends and all, and get to socialise and all. Tell her how I feel.
People will be playing it and it's going to get more popular and people just like it far more. It's a really good, good sport. Like, it's, everyone loves it, like, and you can't get enough of it against the wall. It's just at dinner time. It's great. Like, it's really promoting it well.
Handball is a great way to like relieve boredom. Like when you're out in the house, just sitting in the house, just pick up the ball, find an empty wall and just get off the wall. It's brilliant.
It's marvellous to see the children out on every spare space of wall. At break time, even two together, three or four, they queue up here in the hall at break time just to get onto a board and to play. Now, we have very limited facilities at the moment, but we're working on it and we're trying to get some extra funding to put up some more boards for them.
The great thing about handball is that we see youngsters playing handball that really weren't interested in any other sports, didn't play any other sport in school, and there they are out with their ball in their own little space, exercising and having fun and playing with their friends. We're delighted and we hope it goes from strength to strength.
There is no doubt that this school's program has exploded in popularity and size, and expect more of this in 2012 as GAA Handball Ireland will announce major plans for schools who take up the challenge before the World Championships in Dublin.
I like playing handball because it was one-on-one, you know, it's just, you know, it's different from football. Plus it helped my football as well, like, you know, that I was using both sides of my body. I actually found that, you know, my coordination with my left foot and things were better. So, you know, handball can benefit all your other sports. So I like the fact that I didn't have to depend on anyone else.
My problem now as a PE teacher with these handball walls in is all they want to do for PE is play handball. They want to play handball after school. We hope to move on here from indoor handball one walls to an outdoor area where children can play after school in the evenings and weekends and during the summer. We think there's a lot of potential there. It's, the rules are simple, it's accessible, all they need is a ball to play. I think there's definitely a future for it here in Draperstown.
The introduction of this handball walls has just taken us all by storm. GAA has always been very strong here in the parish of Ballinascreen, and we would feed into the parish of Desert Martin also. So the children have come with a certain background from they were babies in the cradle. So basically these handball walls went up last year, and Mr. Mina, as I'm sure he has quite rightly pointed out, has been a handball champion. So his enthusiasm has instilled the enthusiasm within the children. So we're at the very early stages of this now here in St. Colm's, but I can see the growth already. And we're talking children who are jumping out of their skin to buy their own handball, to practice at lunchtime. And really it would be our main aim to try and develop this right across the whole parish and try and involve even children who maybe don't go to St. Colm's High School. Give everybody the opportunity of using these facilities. So really we're very hopeful that handball will take off and maybe we can have our own world champion someday here from the parish of Ballinascreen.
Especially me Nick Frosky, August Tommy S, Blind Screen, you name Colm, August Iskra Lumsa, Lever Chlawa.
If you'd like to learn more on how to introduce GAA handball to your school or club, then please log on to the National GAA Handball website at www.gaahandball.ie. The young stars of Irish handball were out in full force at the One Wall Nationals, with the very real prospect that many could feature in the Olympic Games in the not-too-distant future. I won't be okay and I won't pretend I am. So just tell me today and take my hand. Please take my hand. Please take my hand. Please take my hand. Minor event saw exceptional play all through and eventually climaxed with a USA versus Ireland showdown as Rachael Garcia faced up to Ireland's Young Handballer of the Year, Cork's Katrina Casey. For God's sake, dear. For God's sake, dear. Just say yes. Just say there's nothing holding you back. It's not a test. Nor a trick of the mind, only love. Just say yes, 'cause I'm aching, I know you are too. For the touch of your warm skin as I breathe you in. Casey took the honours there to cement her status as the best under-18s girls player on the planet, and her county colleague Killian Carroll then faced Joshua Garcia from New York in the boys' minor final to decide the destination of that title.
And now. Point.
Provided some of the most sensational rallies of the weekend before Garcia took the spoiled stateside.
I mean, like, it's a great event for me because it took some time after 40 by 20 seeing it. So it was something different, you know. I mean, I took a rest there for a while and I came back into this. It was nice to try something different. And, you know, I found it more fun playing 40 by 20 because I take 40 by 20 a lot more seriously. And sure, like, it was great just to relieve some stress and just have a ball at a game and play a few Americans I've never played before, and sure, it was a great experience.
Killian, as a player, I think he's one of the fastest players I've ever seen. He doesn't let anything get by him, and earlier the first day when I got here, he actually beat me in an exhibition match. Very unexpected. I didn't know how his style of play was, and he beat me fair. And knowing that I was going to play him in the finals, I anticipated his serve, and I just knew that it was going to be a fight to win. He's a really good player.
The fast pace, she has really good left, like both hands, because back in New York and Brooklyn, females don't have like a good opposite hand, so it's really good. I was hitting it really deep to her, and I was surprised that she's getting it back, but it was all in good fun. I told her that in the 2012 world that I'm coming for her in the 19 and under. Like all these Irish kids that are out here, they play really good for their age. And I'm just like so pleased and like excited that like me and my brother got to come with Willie and like Team USA to play in the junior event.
I'm new to the whole handball scene, but it's been absolutely fantastic. It's the first time I've seen a real international flair and flavour to a sporting occasion here, held here in Ireland. It's fantastic, it really was. Some of the display of skill here and fitness levels and overall, you know, family atmosphere.
There was no doubt that the one wall action over the weekend provided impressive viewing and emphasised skill and pace at the highest level. There will be plenty more to come in episode 3 of the GAA Handball Show, where we will see the world's best players in ladies and men's handball battle for the top open honours.